copyrighted program created by the Rio Grande Oil Company.
San Francisco police calling all cars, attention all cars, broadcast 115. A disturbance on the Barbary Coast, that's all.
In searching through the confidential police files of leading Western cities for the true facts of the crimes broadcast on calling all cars, Rio Grande investigators have discovered some fascinating information for motorists. Actual records of mileage and operating costs kept by the largest cities and counties in the West prove that Rio Grande tracks gasoline is not only the fastest, and most powerful gasoline available, but it is also the most economical and efficient. This is the real reason why Rio Grande cracked gasoline continues to be specified year after year to power more police cars, fire engines, and emergency equipment than any other brand. And now it is our great pleasure to introduce Sheriff Dan Murphy of San Francisco County, who will speak from the studios of station KFRC in San Francisco. Sheriff Murphy.
Tonight, Calling All Cars brings you a story from San Francisco's famous old Barbary Coast. A lot has been written about this one-time notorious district. Of course, much of this writing has been greatly exaggerated, as most native San Franciscans know. Before the enactment of the rigid reform laws, which we have now, vice conditions in most cities were undisguised. There was no attempt at concealment, and this was true in San Francisco. The discovery of gold in California in the middle of the past century brought to San Francisco a great many adventurous men of the rough sort. It is not strange that these men sought rough amusement. I recall as a small boy in San Francisco that right on Market Street, there were such places as the old Cafe Royal, where percentage poker games were run in the open. The players in those games could be seen through the uncurtained windows from the sidewalk. In those days, gambling and vice conditions were close to many of our important public thoroughfares. The romantically publicized Barbary Coast was an outgrowth of the mining camps and the rough and ready days of 49. And long after the gold fever had burned out and San Francisco had grown into a great western metropolis, this sore spot of the old days remains. There are some who would say that the Barbary Coast was a showplace. And while many of us old-timers are prone to romance about it, the truth is, as any veteran policeman can tell you, the Barbary Coast was a sordid and unromantic district. It was probably no worse than similar districts in other great American cities during the gaslight era. Violent crimes did occur there, but not with the frequency the popular writers would have us believe. Some crime flourished there for a long time, but eventually it met the end that crime always meets. When the police, backed by a righteous public opinion, set out to put an end to it.
Thank you.
It is late afternoon of a fine spring day early in the present century. Plowing through the white-crested waves before a spanking south wind, the four-masted sailing ship Jeremiah T. seeks the Golden Gate as the bloody sun dips behind the fog bank which swaps over the Farallone, preparing for its slow nocturnal journey across the bay. The first wispy fingers of gray mist are caressing the wooden hull of the Jeremiah T. as he slips between the shrouded portals of the gate. The crew has scurried aloft to regain the mainsail when the first officer observes a half dozen small boats making for the ship through the growing mist. He reports to the skipper at the wheel.
There are several longboats making fast alongside, sir.
Yeah, I've been expecting them. Foreigners straight and
who are they, sir?
Runners for the crimps.
Beg pardon, sir?
Oh, I forgot you'd never made this port before, Mr. Johnson.
No, sir. This is my first voyage in the Pacific.
Now, make fast that line, Peterson. It's flopping like an old mate's petticoat.
Aye, sir.
You know, Mr. Johnson, these runners are a great help when you're in the fix I am.
I don't understand, sir.
Yeah, we have to stay in port nearly a month before we get another cargo. By the time the runners have gotten to work on the crew, we'll not have a handful of men left. They'll all be in those Whitehall boats heading for the Barbary Coast.
But that's desertion.
Of course it is. By the light of St. Elmo, that's just what I want the crew to do. They desert, and I don't have to pay a man jack of his wages.
But what do we do when we're ready to sail?
No, we'll get another crew from the crimps who run the boarding houses.
Gang hide?
Well, call it that. They'll be a little drunk when we get them aboard, but they'll straighten up once we get free. Oh, Mr. Johnson, I saved the men's back wages and all the wages I'd have to pay them while we're in port. Pretty cute, wouldn't you say?
I'd say it was a little hard on the men.
Oh, you're soft, Mr. Johnson. You've had too much of those North Atlantic steamships.
I don't see why the men will be so willing to leave without their pay. Why, they've got 3 months' wages coming.
Well, I've been running them for 10 days now, serving them miserable food, breaking their backs, feeling the bills.
Yes, I've noticed you've been working them harder than usual.
Hawkins! Hawkins, you dog! Go back up there and reef that sail right, or I'll break every bone in your blasted body.
All right.
Oh, they'll be willing to leave right enough when these runners get through them. Look, they're coming over the side now.
I suppose you didn't want them to take the crew.
Yeah, nothing much I could do about it. They're armed to the teeth and they're all tough. Just watch them go to
come along with me. May board thrown the same boarding house.
Hi there, Mike. Would you like some gin and pepper?
Aye, that I would.
And you'll go on the lake, same expenses boarding house order.
Sure, I stay here with the skipper. Correct, Mooney.
Listen, then fix you up with Mooney, snap, gold, anything you like. And then when you want the ship to sea, and all the skipper that going to the south stays on the plastic shore.
No, stay here. Collect money. A good wife and baby in Stockholm. Collect money.
Well, you're coming ashore with me whether you want to or not.
You don't make me go. I stay hard.
You summon Sir Regan, take that. Here, hey, give me a hand with that customer. I have to use my Australian
arm. That's tequila.
Sure, here you are.
Louis not have tequila since we signed on this hell ship in Yucatan.
Ah, you don't like this ship, eh, Louis?
Oh, no, it's muy malo. Keep a workman too hard.
You come with me to Itabo's boarding house. He fix you up with good work, eh?
Give me another drink.
Yes, yeah, mi amigo. Here you are.
Bueno. This very good tequila. Please make Louis feel fun.
Sure, it's good stuff.
You know, Louis, first time knife throw in Yucatan.
Yes.
Louis, throw a knife in the skin.
Come on, Louis, put that knife away. Al inferno, con capitan, you come with me.
No, no, Louis, sit. Keep a life dead cow.
Wait a minute. Louis, look here. Look at these creatures, eh?
Oh, keep a minute of the kid, Louis.
Hey, hey, they wait for you at the tarbo, eh?
No.
Louis, how you like me?
Yes, all right, eh? That one. Hey, wait a minute.
Yeah, yeah.
Let me I know a redhead in Panama once. He required un día cuando me fui a su casa donde vivió el muchacho.
No.
No.
Y Charbo,
he got his red hat too.
Sí. Sí.
Qué buena. Give me another drink tequila, then we got to the car with Bronco.
At Port of Jeremiah T, the ship is without a crew, and the Whitehall boats are gliding through the fog toward the waterfront, each with its load of befogged sailors upon whom the dope liquor has by now taken its effect. Itabo's crimp, or boarding house, to which Manuel, the runner, leads his boat, is built out over the black water of the bay, and a rickety staircase leads from afloat through a trap door into a back room of the resort. As Manuel ties up his boat, Itabo, an evil-looking Spaniard, slumps down the stairs, lantern in hand.
Well, Manuel, how many this time?
I get three, boss.
Only three? What's the matter with you?
Only three Mexicanos aboard. I tried to get big German fellow. I bite his ear. But three-finger Mike from Shanghai Pete twist his arm in your Shanghai Pete's name. So I have to let him go.
$100 for our
trouble at the last minute. The skipper will take it out of his wages before he gets quit on the show. I do not want to send any more corpses out to the Lima.
While Manuel rows another victim of the bows out to the waiting ship, Luis Gomez and his companion sleep it off in the back room of the crimp. And late the next afternoon, as the dazed and bewildered sailors are struggling to wakefulness, Itabo enters the room.
All right, amigo, get up. I have at last got you a bird on a fine keeper.
What you say?
The capitan is waiting outside for you to sign the article.
Where's the redhead that fellow tell me about, eh?
Redhead? Oh. mi amigo, you were so drunk last night. The red-headed senorita, she come to see you, but you would not move. You only groaned like a pig.
Like a pig? Be careful why you said to Luis Gomez.
Huh?
I shall sleep the thought the men who have said that.
And I have split many a pig before you. Now, get into this.
Don't you show me.
Tell you, I will throw you.
Get in there.
Manuel.
See?
Throw some water on that cockerel's face. Wake him up.
See, sir, sir.
All right, you two, into the saloon.
See, this is north. Sorry, Capitan, but we fell on the floor and need a little persuasion.
That's all right. I'll give him plenty of tea with our own pain.
Now, you two, sign these papers.
What these papers say, senor?
They are Phipps' articles for the big con. I found you a bird.
Where she sails, senor?
Where do you care, sign them?
Oh, but, senor...
Sign them! Do you want to get what Gomez got?
For when? Take my card.
That is fine. And you two?
Si, senor.
Now, Manuel, how about a difficult one?
His water will bring him to...
Oh, look, the thing you saw there. I'll break your arm. So hard.
I warn you, do not draw your gun, for my knife is twisted around your
hand. Manuel, you're standing over the trap. Can you reach the lever?
I will try.
Lord Wolf, stand where you are. Stop!
Hands in the air.
Yes, senor. I come. I'm glad you come.
My car is hard to buy.
Take him down, will you, Bolton?
Yes, sir. Here you are, sir. A knife.
I did not intend to use it, senor. Oh, I'm glad you come.
All right, sir. Stand aside, you two, while I throw the anchor level.
Oh, mother of God. What is that? They're
dropping the anchor. They didn't give a very safe place to hide, Thomas. Look at that other thing lashing around in there as the anchor falls. If I hadn't found it just now, you'd have been killed to bits in the middle of that pile of sea.
Oh, more gracias. You need the gracias. So has saved my life. Oh, I'm glad you found me, senor. Oh, I'm glad you found me. Oh, Santa Maria, un momento más y yo hubiera muerto en este cuarto interno. You have saved my life. You know, you have saved my life.
Not for very long, I'm afraid. You'll probably lose it on the gallows at San Quentin.
Dramatic courtroom scene in which Luis Gomez argued for his life on the plea of self-defense, the jury was sufficiently influenced to save his life. But public opinion was changing, and no barbaric host crime was permitted to go unpunished. The Luis Gomez, unfortunate victim of the Shanghaiing racket, was sentenced to San Quentin Penitentiary for 20 years on a verdict of murder in the second degree. During this broadcast, a telegram was received from Phoenix, Arizona. It reads:
Arizona's largest county, Maricopa, has just placed its new contract for a year's supply of gasoline for all sheriff's cars and other emergency equipment with the Rio Grande Oil Company, specifying Rio Grande cracked gasoline exclusively.
This is Rio Grande's big year. Police and officials of Oakland, Berkeley, Los Angeles, and many other leading western cities and counties have convincingly endorsed Kraft gasoline by renewing contracts for 1936 with Rio Grande. But even more important, the sales of Rio Grande Kraft gasoline to all motorists have increased 140%. Have you changed yet to the fastest growing gasoline in the West?
Police calling all cars. Attention all cars. A cancellation of broadcast 115 regarding a disturbance on the Barbary Coast. Disturbance is now quieted. That's all.
You will have a special new program. You will hear space. Read about the space. Read a free copy. Read about the special new program you will hear this month.